point you are cross borders. You must be prepared to encounter unknown.
So this is how a city may look in the future. Welcome to the presentation of the 7th Framework Project Metropolis. My name is Jacco Hoekstra from TU Delft, and in the next couple of minutes I will walk you through some of the ideas of our project on how we could move people and parcels through the airspace of such a city. Nowadays, we get into our car, our bus, on our motorbike and transverse over the busy highways and roads. With so many of us, this has led to congestion, noise and air pollution, and in certain cases even complete gridlock. Imagine a future in which this may change, when more and more people will be able to operate personal air vehicles, the so-called flying cars. And we will have probably most of our express goods delivered by small, unmanned flying vehicles. So altogether, we may leave solid ground and move up in the air, but will we take our problems with us? How can we fly safely and avoid collisions in an efficient way? How can we reach a high capacity? Would it require a lot of airspace structure or none? Which mode of operation in general would work best? In Metropolis, we investigated 4 different concepts. 4 partners each developed a concept to ensure a safe operation. The results were 4 very different solutions to the same problem. Moving from concept to concept, we gradually introduced a more structured way of operation. Starting off with pure chaos, the 4th concept ends with central control. Subsequently, the solutions were assessed to identify its strong and weak points. The first solution is called full mix. The full mix concept can also be seen in nature, when a swarm of bees enter or leave a beehive. Without any observable structure, each bee reaches its destination without colliding with others. With the full mix concept, we try to simulate that. We equipped all vehicles with tools to automatically detect and resolve conflicts in order to avoid collisions. Furthermore, all vehicles operate directly from origin to destination without any route or altitude restrictions. There's no consideration of priority, and all vehicles operate on their preferred altitudes. Considered by some to be the most efficient way of operation, it may also be dangerous as all vehicles fly crisscross through the air. The second concept is called layers, as it uses a layered approach. In layers, we divided the air in slices, each slice with a limited degree of heading freedom. As a result, vehicles in the same layer operate in the same general direction, thereby reducing the relative speed. To reach its destination, each vehicle needs to climb to that particular layer which corresponds with the intended heading. Vehicles that climb or descend will have to give way to vehicles that fly level. In nature, we see a similar behavior in flocks of birds, all lined up in the same direction and thereby limiting the chance of collisions. Layers incorporate more structure, which may benefit safety, possibly at the cost of efficiency, as suboptimal altitudes have to be flown to reach a destination. The third solution, called zones, introduces even more structure. In zones, a spiderweb-like structure is created to control the flow of traffic in and out as well as around the city. Rings take the aircraft from one side of the city to another, while radials lead the vehicles to and from the city center. Each ring and each radial has one direction only, so a path algorithm has been created to calculate the most efficient path from origin to destination along this structure. The resulting traffic pattern shows resemblance with ants crawling to and from the anthill in tightly structured flows. While layers incorporated some structure, zones take it a step further. Tightly controlled routes make it that aircraft will have to adhere to their routes, even though they may change altitude or speed to avoid collisions. With zones, every aircraft flies the same direction on each leg, thereby reducing the relative speed even further. And not being too restricted in altitude, zones may show some efficiency benefit. The most structured approach is the fourth concept, called tubes. Tubes not only define the aircraft path in 3D space, but also in time. In this concept, each flight follows a bubble through a predefined tube to ensure sufficient separation with other aircraft. Each altitude layer has a tube structure on its own, with reducing granularity at higher altitudes. You can think of tubes as the tube of a city subway system, and then always being on time. Tubes are joined by nodes. Smart algorithms ensure that at most one aircraft is at the node at the same time. In addition, tubes are only used in one direction, and although multiple aircraft may use the same tube at the same time, speed control ensures safety within each tube. With the highest degree of structure, tubes ensure a priori that all aircraft are separated. However, not allowing any freedom in path or altitude does have its impact on efficiency. Layers seem to have an overall safety benefit, so a lower collision risk without hampering the flight efficiency too much. But each of the concepts have their own pros and cons. So for a discussion on these issues, check out the website on the link below, where you can find more information on the project Metropolis.